Hey guys, Mike here, one go short play, playing arcade classics for the Sega Mega Drive. Something tells me this is not Sega endorsed. That's pretty fun. A little rough around the edges. Again, feels a bit Amiga PD. Wow. Oh, licensed to Sega, okay. Ooh, that's a bit nicer, despite it being the same graphics. Wow, actual centipede, actual missile command. Okay, let's find out. One player. Yeah, it still feels a little bit amateurish the way it's all put together. Okay, yeah. I don't know how true to the original centipede this is. It sounds pretty true to it. I'm vaguely familiar with the Atari 2600 version. I have to admit, I don't really go for the dead old school games myself. I'm a child of the late 80s, early 90s games era. Oh, that's nasty. Is it like unnecessarily slowing down? It definitely feels a lot harder to play than other versions of Centipede I've played before on the 2600 and on main. I'm not sure it's particularly true to the original, but oh man, but I'm probably not the authority on this. You might notice it's pretty difficult to talk and play. We'll do our best. I'm going to just hold the fire button down. I'm sure it was a lot easier to play Centipede than this version's making it out to be. Oh yes. Staying in one place and holding the fire button seemed to do the trick that time. They're going to be coming down here, aren't they? Let's have that. Let's have ya, you little weird pieces of centipede, sentient body parts. Not that sentient. They seem to fail to grasp the fact that I'm down here. And without all that messing about, they could just come and get me. Unless, of course, they're not actually aiming for me at all. You know what? I think with games of this era, it's best not to ask the motives of the characters in the game. I mean, turn into mushrooms when you die. Is that based in fact in any way, shape, or form? The ship, is it a ship? The you, the player, has got a weird, a very weird trajectory. Well, speed, it changes speed randomly. It could be related to the amount of sprites on the screen. Really, Sega Mega Drive? Slow down when there's too many sprites on the screen. I've never seen a Mega Drive do that. Although, admittedly, there are a lot of sprites on this particular screen. Yeah, now it's going pants fast. Yeah, I'm not sure why. Something seems amiss with the frame rate. Not frame rate. Well, the speed of the game. There. Which we're not happy. I can't resist the urge now. Oh, no. Oh, no numbers. I'm going to stop whinging about that one day. Gee, and you know I've got to go through this process if the opportunity comes up. One go. I used to do it just so you knew it was me doing the videos every time, whenever the opportunity came up. Okay, that was Centipede. Let's see at least one other arcade classic. This is like an official thing then, isn't it? It's not very good. I hated Pong and Missile Command. I can't imagine Missile Command would work well on the Mega Drive. Oh, Sega version. Oh, go on, let's do Centipede Sega version then. This is the Sega version. This is how Sega do it. Okay, so far, not so different. Oh, hello. It's got a background. That's literally all that's changed. It's gone from black to grass. Oh, the spider's different. The little pieces of Centipede, are they different? I think they might be actually. It's really not very pretty though. Is this off Sega roll? Is he step fast now? Yeah, it's just down to the amount of centipede bits, isn't it? It's the amount of centipede bits, isn't it? That spider is barely visible. Not a lot of thought has gone into this. Oh, don't like it. Don't like it. I never really liked centipede. I'm sorry, guys. I know there's going to be people watching this video who really love this era of games. I never did. I was... 1978 I was born, so I was a kid in the 80s, you know, so I got my first Spectrum, my first computer was a Spectrum, and I got it 1987, I was 9, I hadn't really seen computer games up to that point. I had a caveman, I tell a lie, I had a caveman machine, one of those grandstand machines. I had caveman, that was the first gaming experience I had. And my brother got from Toys R Us in 1987, I think. I know it was around then because we watched Aliens the same night we got it for the first time on telly. So, is that 87? 86, 87? The Aliens would have been on telly? I don't know. And we watched it in my friend's house. Anyway, my brother got a Tomytronic, and it was the one, the purple one with the spaceships coming down from above you and you're the tank. Do you remember that one? That was my first gaming experience, those two games. And then a Spectrum. And then the late 80s, early 90s kind of boom of 16-bit games was just amazing to me. The early Spectrum games were very good for me. They're the later ones that people who say the true specky people don't like, was my era. And I think they were awesome. I especially loved Ocean's version of Shadow Warriors on the Spectrum. I don't know if you ever saw that. It was boss. Anyway, off on the tangents, but really not into that. That was my point. What arcade classics? Yeah, for the Sega Mega Drive. Thanks for watching.